Ghana's strategies to create job opportunities and reduce poverty have taken center stage in the policy-making process over the years. SNV Netherlands Development Organization has been a strategic partner in this process since 1992. In February 2011, SNV started the implementation of the High Impact Tourism Training Program in partnership with the Opportunities Industrialization Center Ghana, with funding from the European Commission. The overall objective of which was to contribute to sustainable pro-poor economic growth and development in Ghana.
The main objective of the project is to contribute to sustainable pro-poor economic growth in 7 least development countries. And the main target is unemployed, underemployed and disadvantaged groups. So in Ghana, we have targeted mainly the youth within the age group between 18 and 35 who have no skill, have just finished the GSS or SSS, and we have targeted them as one of the groups that we have trained. We have also trained street food vendors who need the skills to be able to provide professional service to the public in terms of presenting food professionally, preparing food also professionally and hygienically so that they don't present any harm to the general public. We have been able to train over 1,200 beneficiaries, both the youth and the street food vendors combined. And at the moment, some of them have begun to secure jobs in the hospitality industry. This has been one of the main objectives of the project, to be able to provide opportunities for the unskilled to be able to access the job market.
As a collaborative effort, the OICG was very instrumental not only in the development of the proposal, but also in the use of the facilities at their center for the training of some of the beneficiaries, for which the executive director is very satisfied.
The HEAT project is looking at making the tourism sector accessible to women and unskilled and semi-skilled youth. And OICG, as I being the local partner, was assigned to implement the training for the street food vendors. And the objective for that component was to enable the street food vendors operate culturally authentic food vending in a safety way and with a very good customer service. In fact, it's been a very nice experience for OICG, because I can confidently say that the capacity of my staff, and for that matter, for the organization as a whole, has been built with this exposure.
Consultants were contracted to offer services in the form of training of trainers, as well as directly training the beneficiaries of the HEAT project.
The program was designed to train a certain number of people, and it was to run for a period of 12 weeks for each training, and our company, Hospitality Plus, was to do 8 batches. Participants who registered for these programs were JSS school leavers, SS school leavers, and with or without any knowledge about hospitality at all, registered for this program. And for the 12-day training for each batch, we went through topics like introduction to tourism and hospitality, customer care, then communication skills, and we focused more on hospitality programs in the areas of housekeeping and food and beverage service. The courses went through successfully.
Uniquely, the training was very flexible in the choice of language of instructions in order to reflect the diverse backgrounds of the beneficiaries of the project, in line with the composition of the street vendors.
In terms of the impact on street food vendors, we think that it's been very, very useful and valuable, because they've been able to identify why they should do things in certain ways to be able to prevent outbreaks through the way they prepare food and the way they serve their clients. And they have been able to appreciate the reasons behind why they should change their behavior. We have been able to develop training materials for waiters and for room attendants, which the industry would be able to use subsequently for any training within the sector of the hospitality industry.
At the end of the program, trainees were awarded certificates of participation with which to continue on their jobs, better equipped to make a better living. In order to fulfill the objectives of the program, a monitoring system was put in place where the resource persons visited the beneficiaries who had gotten jobs to monitor their performance on the job. And those who had not yet secured any job would meet with the resource persons from time to time to give a feedback on their job search. Beneficiaries of the training were elated about the knowledge and skills they acquired and were very appreciative to SNV. They could not hide their excitement and call for more of such opportunities to be extended to other areas.
I got to know about the high impact tourism training and I decided to go for it. And I was one of the people that were trained in SNV training. And during the training, it was an interesting moment and I got to learn a lot of things. We did practicals, we went through teamworks, we were given lots of assignments and it really helped me a lot because now I'm out of the training and I have a lot in my hands. Like, I just got this job due to the training and it has really built my communication skills. It has really changed my person.
Mosrungcho jajenyenya ale kenene bia wududu na le banawududu a pakla le kenena mo drove an flopo le gbo le kwade ma ba custom ava gbo ale kenena akwa ma ale kenena le banawududu kple wa me akanto na wadram ha ale kenena le bana do kio kwo fa surrounding kata le kenena chubalala to hede na ma banana ma ba flo wadu ma ga kpo do lelele ko le kwade ma mo dro chu na tefo bubu va na mi adju ko ma ba flo na wu Zigadamo complain about Ududua Yodula, Manuna Yo, Kakan, you can even stroll the OIC class and Vito Bo. I mean, I did them when I am a drew to the Pobo Bamfla, and another Yapo don't have Taka come, Daddy, and me custom of Ovo Hope.
I mean, Wami P. Jack, she fair say, no mere care in Teja, no, near Niako Fair, where near here. She, I mean, honey in Casino Cochomia, she can't in the market, Sakashi. Mana keshi ni eni ni your table no ni hygiene sa ke mani ma he no agbe ne hu e amewa mi akeshi no fia no sa ke man he o mo di akeshi ma fake appreciation akeshi ni eni ya he ani mi gbe shi lo mi na se agbe ne the third one ji cho mi akeshi ame ha ni kase ni ni e ha ni environment e fe clean cho mi akeshi eni your ife le neat ko ni ke gbo e ba na me ba ye ni e ame ye ni e like na me na he wale agbene hu e boy wo modin akeshi due mo na mecho wo fe nke ba tuni the way ni ma entertaining customer ni e ba ba ni mahale ni e ni e agbene hu e ke hale ni e itanle hu e the way ni kele ba jue keno ko ni fault ko ye ni e he be ne ba ke ni na kan be ni kele ba jue na kan je be ni amecho mi ni bi pin ni ile ni bi pin ye SNV
really they have done well to us. And whatever they have taught me, we have to use it to do the work that we are doing. That is what you know is good and it will benefit to all people in Ghana here. And we appeal to them that they will extend so that the next step, other people too, can benefit out of it.
I'm going to go to the market. I'm going to go to the 2 weeks I'm church. In fact, ma sua de bebre o mama sai aba me market mo pa because first no obi be to ade na wo form na okọ 121 nko form mienu miensa ba me obi am ba biom but me che ya de say me yefa de ne go form yefa go table so go table so a e din fa so be my because e go form ho no ma malaria ne cholera yenya ne nyina ne yenya wo form ade a yeto no mama be kire me ade a in fact many ajipa manka na me dada mo.
As with every human endeavor, a few challenges were identified in the course of the implementation of the project, which the project coordinator believed, if taken into account, subsequent project would be even more successful.
We have had a number of challenges, mainly the budgets. that we had to work with, given the target of 1,200 beneficiaries. The budget that had been allocated to the country was quite a constraint, but we've been able to get through it. We would suggest that in the future, when any project of such a nature and scope is being implemented, the budget should be really critically looked at.
Overall, the country director of SNV Ghana, Amogoyen Keita, was very satisfied with the success of the project and encouraged by the enthusiasm with which people accepted the project and were calling for more. However, according to him, other areas of equal importance were also in line for attention.
High impact tourism training project is part of one of the cross-cutting themes of SNV, which is vocational education. And we got this project from the European Commission, and it was implemented in many countries in Africa and Asia. And this project, from my point of view, is a big success because it came to address one of the key issues in Africa, and particularly in Ghana, the issue of the support of the human capital when we talk about the informal sector. The informal sector is part of our activities. I rather call it the real economy. And we all, for example, eat from the street because we buy many things from the street. And one of the focus of this project was to support the street vendors. And I personally went to an event where many street vendors were gathered, and I was really impressed by their testimony. They were really happy to see that a project came to address their issues. They want to be more skillful. They want to serve better, but they didn't know how. And this project came to help them, to support them, to provide the right skills to them. And I think when the street vendors are skillful, our health also will be positively affected because the sanitation issues, the health issues will be solved regarding the food they are selling. So from my point of view, it is definitely a big success.
Thank you, SNV. I'm very grateful to you.